Hi, welcome back to my channel. Thank you for watching and for subscribing. And if you're just visiting, please consider subscribing. So today is a very exciting video. I'm going to share with you my top heavy hair fragrances. Now, this video concept was created by my friend Nisha Spicy Looks, and she tagged me to do it. Thank you for tagging me, Nisha. And if you're not familiar with her channel, you absolutely must check it out. It is linked in the description. She has absolutely amazing collection and makes beautiful videos. So please make sure to check out her channel. Now, I loved this video concept because I love heavy hitter fragrances. This is probably my favorite category of fragrances, and I think right now is the perfect time to do this video because we tend to pull out our heavy hitters during fall and winter. So the way I'm going to do this video is I actually decided to rank my fragrances from number 10 to number 1. Now, of course, I could have chosen many more heavy hitter fragrances. I have quite a lot in my collection, but I decided to narrow it down to top 10. Now, pause the video for a second and put your guesses down in the comments. What do you think my number one heavy hitter is going to be? I would love to know your guesses. Just do it very quickly. And without further ado, let's get started with the list. So even though, you know, we tend to think about fall and winter fragrances as our heavy hitters, I think there are quite a few summer and spring fragrances that could be or are considered heavy hitters as well. And so I have a few of those on my list. And I'm going to start with such a fragrance. In my number 10 spot, I have a fragrance from Zirjoff, and it is Herba Pura. What a gorgeous bottle and what a gorgeous scent. This to me is an explosion of sweet fruits with musk. So there are a lot of different fruits and citruses, and there is musk and there is vanilla and I think amber as well. But mostly I just get a bowl of different types of fruits with some citruses added in, and they're all swimming in musk. This is absolutely addictive, captivating, and what an amazing heavy hitter. So heavy hitter to me is the fragrance that lasts long, that projects well, and that leaves a great sillage. And this one checks all three categories. This is gorgeous. Could have easily been ranked higher, but somehow it ended up in number 10 spot. So again, this is Herba Pura from Zirjoff. So in number 9 spot, I have another fragrance that is probably more suited for warmer weather, although of course wear whatever you want, whenever you want. I always say that and I can continue to say that. This one is Secrets du Paradis Rouge from Jewel et Mad. This fragrance is mostly about sweet orange blossom. So this has, like I said, orange blossom, it has neroli, it has vanilla, it has honey, it has amber, some woody notes, some other floral notes. There are a lot of notes in this fragrance, but mostly it's sweet honeyed orange blossom. And I have quite a few kind of sweet orange blossom fragrances in my collection, but this one is definitely the strongest. This one is the most powerful. When I spray this, I can smell it on me all day long. I don't even have to overspray. You know, I can spray it like a normal person would spray it, and it still lasts and projects all day long. And when you first spray it, it just fills up the room. And when you walk, it leaves an amazing sillage. This is a powerhouse of a fragrance. If you love sweet orange blossom and you're looking for something really strong, this is a great one to try. Number 8 spot goes to a fragrance from Carolina Herrera. This is from her Confidentials line, and this is called Nightfall Patchouli. I have 3 fragrances from this line, and this one is the strongest by far. Now, the name is kind of deceiving. I've mentioned it before. You know, Nightfall Patchouli, you might think this fragrance is all about patchouli, and it is not. Yes, patchouli is present here, but it is not earthy patchouli at all. It is definitely sweet chocolatey patchouli. And then you also have cinnamon in here. You have benzoin. I think you might have other spices in here as well. And this fragrance is just so sweet and so warm and so enveloping and kind of cozy and sexy at the same time. Sweet, spicy, with a bit of patchouli. It's just incredible. I absolutely love the scent profile of this fragrance. It is gorgeous. It is perfect for the type of weather that we're having now. Like right now, we're having this really kind of a gloomy, dark, rainy type of day. And this type of fragrance, I would love to wear in this kind of weather. It just kind of warms me up, cheers me up. Now, is this the biggest heavy hitter in my collection? No, that's why it's at number 8 spot, but it is definitely heavy hitter in my opinion, and it is the strongest scent from this Confidentials line. So again, this is Nightfall Patchouli from Carolina Herrera. And the bottle is so heavy, it almost fell out of my hand. Number 7 spot goes to a fragrance from Initio Parfums. This is Psychedelic Love. Now, I've had quite a relationship with this fragrance because this wasn't surprisingly a blind buy for me. I had a sample of this fragrance that I tested for quite some time, and this wasn't love at first sniff. Originally, I wasn't the biggest fan of this fragrance. I just thought, okay, it's a little bit strange. It's not exactly for me. I don't think I need to have a full bottle. And the more I tested it, like something kept pulling me towards this fragrance, and I kept testing it and testing it. And the more that I did that, the more I fell in love with the scent. It is very interesting and very unique to my collection. Now, there are a number of different florals in here. Ylang Ylang, there is a rose, there is heliotrope, there's also sandalwood and myrrh. The floral note that I'm getting more than anything else is heliotrope, because it definitely has slightly powdery and very nutty type of touch. I'm definitely getting sandalwood. It's creamy and it's woody. And I'm getting myrrh because it has a resinous touch. So it is a very sexy, again, very sexy scent. It's a little bit resinous, it is creamy, it is woody, it is nutty, it is just a touch powdery. What a gorgeous scent. My favorite from Initio Parfums, definitely my favorite. Now, I kind of heard some reviews where this scent can be tricky for people. Like, it sort of depends on their body chemistry. For some people, it really works. For some people, it really doesn't work. I guess I am one of the lucky ones that this scent works on. This is gorgeous on. Absolutely captivating scent. And again, performance is amazing. To me, this is a definite heavy hitter. Number 6 spot goes to a fragrance from the House of Tom Ford. And you know, we often bash Tom Ford for poor performance. I mean, take Lost Cherry, for example, terrible performance. Well, okay, no, I take it back. Not terrible on me, but I know it's terrible on many people. And even though it's not terrible on me, it's not great. Take Eau de Soleil Blanc, a beautiful summer fragrance, terrible performance. There are quite a few others, but there are also quite a lot of scents in Tom Ford line that have great performance, that are definitely heavy hitters. And the next one that I included is Noir Parfum. This is definitely heavy hitter, such a strong fragrance. I usually like wearing this when it's quite cold outside, because I find this one even a little bit too much when it's a little bit warm. Like, this would be sort of a late fall, winter type of scent for me. This is, to me, a spicy vanilla. There is vanilla here, there are a lot of spices, there are some woody notes, and there is this interesting note of coffee, which is Indian ice cream. And it brings such a nice touch, such a nice punch to this fragrance, because it gives it that sweetness, but in a slightly different way. I think I've never tried coffee, I've never even seen coffee, but I think it has some spices in it as well. So this one is definitely very spicy, again, very warm scent, very, very powerful. For me, this is perfect for really cold days, but performance on this one is absolutely outstanding. And so we made it to the top five. In number five spot, I have another fragrance from the house of Tom Ford. Can you believe it? Two Tom Ford fragrances on my heavy hitter list, but I had to include them. This one is Tobacco Vanille from Tom Ford. Again, this is a fragrance that wasn't love at first sniff for me. In fact, even a few years ago, I really, really disliked this fragrance. Couldn't imagine wearing it. To me, it was extremely masculine. And you know, this is a proof of how much our noses mature with time, how much our tastes change, because right now, I don't see anything masculine in this scent. This is definitely, definitely unisex. Anyone can wear it, men and women. This is another vanilla scent, but this one is kind of smoky vanilla. It has vanilla, it has tobacco, it has dried fruits in it, it has some woody notes. And this is the type of tobacco that kind of has that cherry vibe, a bit of a even cherry pit to me. So it's a bit of dried fruits together with cherry, together with tobacco smoke and with vanilla. Tobacco is not too much. It's not like, you know, you've been smoking all night or sitting beside someone who was smoking all night. No, it's such a elegant type of tobacco in here, and mixed together with all the other notes makes this fragrance quite beautiful. And again, I'm going to repeat it over and over again in this video because it is about heavy hitters, and this one is definitely such a fragrance. Performs well, projects well, leaves a really nice sillage. So Tobacco Vanille is my number five. Let's go to number four. This is where things really got difficult, because really my top four, or rather let's say number four, three, and two could have been easily interchanged. All of them are amazing heavy hitters, but let's go with how I placed them. And so number four goes to Roses Berberanza from Maison Lancôme. This was my first purchase from this line. This is the fragrance that made me fall in love with this line. And even though I have many more from this line now, this still remains my absolute number one. The scent profile is stunning and the performance is amazing. So in the opening, of course, this fragrance is very famous for having that blast of pistachios, which really offends some people. I can totally understand it. For me, it's amazing. I love it. It's so different. It's so addictive to my nose. And then when it settles down, you have, you know, this sweet, jammy rose together with rum and together with raspberries coming through. And it kind of, you know, balances out the pistachios. Pistachios are always there, but definitely they're blending together with everything else, not as strong as they are in the opening. Such an addictive, gorgeous scent. It's not a safe blind buy, in my opinion, because of the pistachio opening. I would definitely recommend sampling it first before buying it. But if you enjoy that deep, jammy, slightly boozy rose with some fruitiness and nuttiness added in, this is an amazing one to try. I'm kind of confused about this Maison Lancôme line, and there are a lot of rumors about this and that being discontinued. I don't know at this point. I'm kind of lost in what's discontinued and what's not. Many say that this fragrance is discontinued, which is a total shame, but I think you can still find it on discounters. It pops up there quite often. So again, if you enjoy the type of scent profile, check this one out for sure. And so we're down to top three. Number three spot goes to another fragrance from the house of Zherjof. This is Naxos. This is an interesting scent again, because even a couple years ago, I wouldn't have had this in my collection. I wouldn't have been able to wear it. I would have considered it very masculine. That's no longer the case. It is unisex. It is very popular for a good reason. It's a stunning fragrance. The opening is quite aromatic because I'm getting a blast of lavender, and it's a lavender that has a bit of a mentholy touch to it. And then honey and tobacco are coming out. I mean, mostly this fragrance is about honey and tobacco, and it becomes so warm. It becomes so cozy. It becomes absolutely incredible. It tones down that initial lavender. In fact, the lavender kind of disappears for me almost completely. It becomes all about tobacco and honey. It is gorgeous, stunning, heavy hitter. It is a real heavy hitter. It is strong. It is powerful. It's amazing. You must try Naxos. Don't think that it's masculine. Really, it is not. Women can wear this one any day. Number two possibly can surprise you. I'm not sure. This is a designer fragrance, but just because it's designer doesn't mean it's not heavy hitter. In fact, this is one of the biggest heavy hitters in my collection. That's why I put it at number two. And it's another offering from the House of Lancôme. This is La Nuit Trésor. What an amazing scent. I love the scent profile here. It is so smoky and captivating and sensual and sexy and deep and strong. It's amazing. Of course, there are a lot of fruits in here. There is vanilla, there is praline, caramel, there is patchouli, there is incense, coffee, there are some woody notes. I'm sure there are a ton of notes that I missed. And it definitely has that coffee, chocolatey kind of vibe mixed together with this array of fruits. And it has praline and caramel and vanilla mixing together with patchouli, making this amazing, deep, chocolatey kind of sweet base. And then you have incense making this whole thing smoky. What a seductive scent. This one is quite strong. For me, this scent is for like special occasion or going out in the evening. Like if I was going out on a date, on a romantic date in the evening, this would be a scent I would wear. Or if I have some kind of formal event in the evening, I would wear this one. This one is so strong that for me, it's almost a little bit too much to wear during the day, because when I wear this, this is making a commitment. I have to make a commitment to the scent. It stays on the whole day. It projects quite strongly the whole day. People that are around me can smell me the whole day. This is a powerhouse of a fragrance. So that's why I mostly gravitate towards this scent as a special event type of scent. But it is an amazing heavy hitter. Amazing. Very, very strong with an amazing scent profile. So La Nuit Trésor takes number two spot. So that brings us to number one. Now, did you make a guess? Please tell me you made some guesses. If you have watched me for a while, then I don't think number one will come as a surprise. I have a feeling that many of you would guess what my number one scent is. This is absolutely, hands down, the biggest heavy hitter in my collection. In fact, even though I struggled placing some of the other fragrances on this list, number one was always clear to me from the beginning. As soon as I started thinking about this video and what fragrances I was going to include, I knew right away what my number one heavy hitter will be. And it is, of course, it is Rosé Eau de from Gallagher Fragrances. This is a beast. This is incredible. I mean, look at the bottle. You might think that I have not worn it a lot because the bottle looks basically full. But let me tell you, I have worn it a lot. And you have to use this one in moderation. There is no overspraying this fragrance or it will choke you out. It is so, so strong and it is so powerful. I think I would be happy to wear this fragrance, honestly, every single day. If it wasn't for the fact that my husband hates it, I don't know what's wrong with him. I don't know how you can hate this fragrance, but he does. And so, you know, to show a bit of respect, I don't wear it all that often, although I still wear it plenty. So what is this fragrance about? Well, it has apple crisp, it has brown sugar, it has honey, it has vanilla, it has patchouli, tonka, and there is a metallic note in here. I know it's the metallic note that bothers some people. I don't get metallic note. And, you know, for my husband, he doesn't hate it because of the metallic note, because I don't think he gets it either. He doesn't like the sour apples in this. He says it smells like rotten apples. I have no idea what he's talking about. This is amazing. I absolutely love the sour apples in here, and especially the way they mix together with honey and brown sugar. It just makes this fragrance special. There's something very, very special about it. When you look at all the individual notes, you know, they might seem like, well, these are your regular run-of-the-mill notes. There's nothing really that stands out so much, that is so complex about the notes. I don't know. The way this is put together makes this fragrance absolutely special and makes it different and makes it absolutely amazing. Anyways, you can tell I can talk about this one for a long time. And what makes this fragrance even more special is the performance, which is out of this world. The everything, the projection, the sillage, the longevity are absolutely amazing. All of them. So that's why this is in number one spot. So there you go. Here's my top 10 list of heavy hitter fragrances. Thank you very much, Nisha, for creating this concept and for tagging me to do it. This was so much fun to choose these fragrances. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up and subscribe. And I would love to know what are some of your heavy hitter fragrances. Please let me know in the comments below. Thank you again for watching. I will see you soon in the next video. Bye.